Welcome to the End Zone on Campus Insiders. The LSU Tigers have lost just 6 games over the past 3 years, but this season could be an anomaly in Baton Rouge, a rebuilding year. To preview the Tigers, we're joined by our managing editor, Pete Futak. And Pete, what concerns you more, defense with just 3 returning starters or the erratic quarterback play of Zach Mettenberger?
How about neither one? I mean, it's LSU. I mean, they get 4- and 5-star talents each and every year. You know, yeah, they lose NFL guys. They replace them with more NFL guys. Les Miles is a talent factory there. That's not going to be a problem on defense. It's going to be the LSU defense. It's going to be fine. Mettenberger's going to be all right. I mean, he just needs a little bit of tweaking, and that's where the quarterback whisperer, Cam Cameron, comes in. Brought aboard to help tutor him. I think this passing game is going to be better. Remember, he's got all the tools. He's got the NFL arm. He's got the talent. He lit up Alabama last year. He just needs a little bit of work, and I think Mettenberger's going to be just fine. I think they're going to be okay.
So as much blame that he receives, we should point out that this team will automatically be in trouble against Alabama and Florida if they don't improve the offensive line.
That was a big problem last year. The offensive line was supposed to be among the best in the country. It was just never healthy. Had a bunch of different problems. But the positive out of that is that all the young talent got chances to work. You got Trey Turner, Lael Collins, Vital Alexander. These are 5-star NFL caliber offensive linemen that got their feet wet last season. They've got to keep Zach Mettenberger upright or this offense isn't going to work. But as fast as that offense needs to gel, with TCU coming up fast, they're going to have to be great right out of the box.
Game 1. Yep. They take on TCU at Cowboys Stadium. So what type of a test do you think the Horned Frogs are going to be?
Big time. I mean, this is a very, very strong TCU team, a lot better than last year. And remember, last year they led the Big 12 in run defense. They get Casey Pahal back at quarterback. The offense is going to be explosive. This is a team good enough to potentially win the Big 12 championship. So if LSU comes out and rolls over the Horned Frogs, you're going to know right away that this is a very, very good Tiger team, and watch out for the rest of the SEC.
All right, prediction time now for you, Pete. LSU last year lost to 3 ranked opponents. So what's realistic for them in 2013?
Problem is that schedule. I think they rebuild in a hurry, but you look what they've got. They got to go to Ole Miss. They got to go to Alabama. I think they lose those 2 games. They still have to deal with Texas A&M. They get a horrendous break in the schedule against the East. They got to go to Georgia. They got to play Florida. Starting out with that game against TCU, there are a lot of landmines. But a couple years ago, they had just as nasty a schedule, if not tougher, and they were able to get to the national championship game. It's national title or bust for a place like LSU, yeah. But I think they're going to go 10-2.
All right, we'll see how things go for Les Miles there in Baton Rouge. For the latest in college football news, keep it here to campusinsiders.com.